Hey, what's going on, everybody? Hope you're all having a great day. I have some interesting news to share with you. This is an update in regards to something you may have heard me mention if you have watched my recent live streams or videos, if you talk to me in Discord, if you hang around with me in the PlayStation party. You may have heard me mention that 60 Minutes was going to possibly be running a story on the UFO UAP phenomenon that is in a more serious light and isn't going to be filled with the usual stigmatized rhetoric nonsense that we're used to, talking about little green men and tinfoil hats and this, that, and the other thing. So this is confirmation. This is a tweet from Leslie Keen, who was one of the writers of the New York Times article that kind of blew the lid wide open on this thing a few years ago. On Sunday, both 60 Minutes and CBS Sunday Morning will be covering UAP. I was interviewed for Sunday Morning by David Pogue. Avi Leb will also be featured. He is the astronomer that contends that Oumuamua, that object, the interstellar object that entered our solar system and then passed by us, was actually possibly artificial in nature and maybe a remnant of a civilization or a probe. He'll be on here, and then it says, and perhaps others who are open-minded but don't take UFOs seriously. So it's going to be a mix of things, I suppose. You know, this is a step in the right direction, but we really need less of the people that are going to be a part of these stories that will try to tell us that an object that is displaying instantaneous acceleration, exhibiting maneuvers with G-forces that shatter what our technology is capable of, G-forces that would kill a human pilot, let alone, you know, rip the fighter jet in half. We need less of these people that are going to try to tell us that these are weather balloons or swamp gas or the usual nonsense. We can't have that right now. Those days are gone, right? Like, we're moving into significant scientific exploration of this topic. We can't keep going down the same old road that tells us these are drones or that they're balloons or that they're Chinese lanterns. And look, I understand that sometimes you get a piece of footage or you get a report of something strange in the sky and it does turn out to be those things, sure. But we're focusing on the cases where it appears that physics is being broken or that an object is following the rules of the highly theoretical quantum physics. You know, a weather balloon, it isn't going to display instantaneous acceleration. It's not going to teleport. It's not going to dematerialize. I mean, find me a drone or a balloon or a bird or an airplane that can do those things. You know, the footage speaks for itself. I'm going to show you guys a short little preview clip from the 60 Minutes story in just a second here. But please keep in mind, like, if you're one of those people out there that doesn't believe this is going on, you got to open up your mind a little bit here. And it's not something that you even have to have, like, faith for. I mean, just look at the data. Look at what has been analyzed thus far. Look at the footage. Look at the evidence. I mean, this is remarkable what's going on. Something is happening. I feel like this is coming to some sort of head. I don't know where this is all going to lead. But I have never seen anything like this as far as how seriously this is actually being taken by people who I wouldn't expect it from. The fact that it's even being given this kind of attention is surprising to me. But that's because there is a concerted effort to change the way the public views this particular topic. I mean, even if you just remove aliens from the equation for just a moment, the idea that there are objects of unknown origin that are entering our airspace with absolute impunity, restricted airspace, military airspace, and they're, you know, outpacing our best fighter pilots, the best technology that we have. They're demonstrating the ability to tamper with electronic systems, actively jam radar, shut off nuclear missile silos, and, you know, are nuclear capabilities in general. They can be wherever they want, when they want. It's mind-boggling. I mean, I'm like tripping over my words here even talking about it, just trying to get the point across that this is technology that we don't have. You know, I know that there's been that saying for God knows how long now that the military is always 4 years ahead. It's like, well, you know, maybe in certain regards, but this is not 40 years ahead. This is like further ahead what these things are doing. But we got to pay attention to this. This is a big deal. There are fundamental questions that human beings have. And sadly, some people don't care about the answers to those questions. Some people actively don't care about where human beings originated from. They don't care if there's life after death. They don't care if there are people visiting us, or beings or organisms of it that are intelligent, that are visiting us from another star system, another planet, another galaxy, another dimension even. Some people just don't care about that, unfortunately, even though I think it's crucial to pay attention to these types of things, and that it's, you know, it, nothing could possibly be more profound. Nothing. I mean, think of something that has more weight than are we being visited by extraterrestrials / is there intelligent life aside from us in the universe? Like, I think that second question's pretty obvious at this point that yes, there is. And I think it's mighty obvious at this point that the first question has already been answered and that yes, they are visiting us, but we need the details now. Who are they? What do they want? What are they capable of? Where are they from? What do they look like? You know, I mean, it's fascinating. I kind of feel like the people that aren't paying much attention to this, if they put themselves out in the middle of their street one day and one of these things landed in front of them, that their minds would quickly change. I do believe that. But the two biggest questions I've always had my entire life: are there extraterrestrials visiting this planet? And, you know, / are they out there? Which, that, you know, now those questions are changing. And what happens when we die? You know, is there an afterlife? And I guess you could kind of lump that in with, you know, is there a God, a divine creator, a divine consciousness, an omnipotent intelligence, a creator of the universe? There are no bigger questions than that. And it feels like we're getting very close to answering one of these, or maybe even two. So I'm going to play the clip for you guys, and then that'll be the end of the video at that point. But thank you for watching, of course. Leave a like if you could. It's greatly appreciated. I'm going to try to give you guys daily updates as much as I can, because this is unraveling very quickly. It's a fluid situation. There's news coming out seemingly every few hours, and it's kind of hard to keep up with at times. And I'm not always available to post anything like this. But when I can, I will. There will be a live stream tonight, of course, and I'll probably be talking about this in the middle of that. I know it's Battlefront. It's, you know, we're playing a game. It's just something I enjoy. I know this is much more serious, and maybe you may be asking yourself, well, how do those two things correlate with each other? They don't necessarily. It's in the middle of a hobby of mine, talking about something important to me. I hope to see you there, of course. Take care and enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks for watching.
Former Navy pilot Lieutenant Ryan Graves calls whatever is out there a security risk. He told us his F-18 squadron began seeing UAPs hovering over restricted airspace southeast of Virginia Beach in 2014 when they updated their jet's radar, making it possible to zero in with infrared targeting cameras.
So you're seeing it both with the radar and with the infrared, and that tells you that there is something out there.
Pretty hard to spoof that.
These photographs were taken in 2019 in the same area. The Pentagon confirms these are images of objects it can't identify. Lieutenant Graves told us pilots training off the Atlantic coast see things like that all the time.
Every day. Every day for at least a couple of years.
Wait a minute. Every day for a couple of years?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't see an exhaust plume.
Including this one, off the coast of Jacksonville, Florida in 2015, captured on a targeting camera by members of Graves' squadron.
Look at that thing! It's rotating. My gosh! They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots from the west. Look at that thing, dude.